Okay, welcome back. This is just going to be a short episode where I put a sword into the bonfire here at Firelink Shrine, and I'm going to read off some item descriptions after that for the items that we found, just in case you're interested. So if you're not interested in the item descriptions, you can just turn this off after the whatever happens when we put the sword here. So I'm going to talk to this lady first, and then we'll get started.
Ashen One, produce the coiled sword at the bonfire. The mark of ash will guide thee to the land of the lords, to Lothric, where the homes of the lords converge.
I already
Very
leveled
well.
Up last time.
Then touch
that's
the
all I've done since the last video is level up. I'll show
Take
you
nourishment from these sovereignless souls.
Show you what nourishment I took from the souls. I put two in endurance, one in vitality, strength, and dexterity, and that's all I did. So here we go.
Farewell, Ashen One. May the flames guide thee.
Go ahead and kindle this bonfire, and then I will probably talk to the blacksmith. Expecting a cutscene, maybe she'll have some new dialogue.
Ashen One, produce the coiled sword at the bonfire. The mark of ash will guide
okay,
to
look.
Farewell.
Ooh. Burn undead bone shard. That's cool. Okay. I'm just gonna leave for now. Still nothing new, huh?
Ashen, pretty, the mark to Lothric.
Lots of little things to ease the burden of a weary traveler. And yes, I'm undead too, but not so charitable as to give my goods away. Ashen One, fetch souls and bring them to me. As is thy wont, no?
So you're the shop? Everybody wants souls.
Ashen One, if my wares are not to thy satisfaction, bring me umbral ash. With ash, I'll fashion new wares. Is it not our sorry fate to sup on death?
Yes, yes, we all use souls. Power key. 20,000. So I need 20,000. Got some spells and some miracles and some boost weapons that I should decorate. Souls. Everybody likes souls. Hey, he looks familiar.
Well, a newcomer, I see.
Sounds
I
familiar.
I am Andre.
It's
I
Andre!
I serve this shrine as a humble smith forging weapons. You're in search of the Lords of Cinder, I trust. A toilsome journey, I'd wager. You'll require good arms. Let me smith your weapons.
I require
some
pants.
I am a smith. Such is my purpose. Weapons and protection are sturdy enough by and large, but when overused, they'll eventually break. When their durability is low, repair becomes a necessity. Use a powder, or simply rest at a bonfire. But should chance impel them break, bring them me. I'll hammer them back into shape. They take no pleasure in breaking, I assure ye. So, handle them with care, if you would. There are two ways to smith weapons. Simple reinforcement is one, and infusion the other. Reinforcement is straightforward. It strengthens a weapon without altering its property. Infusion is a more advanced form of smithing that infuses an element. Reinforcement requires titanite, and infusion requires gems. Bring the stones, and I'll do the smithing. It's my purpose, after all. In battle, your weapons are your only friends. Forge them well, and they won't let you down.
Oh, another gesture. Hurrah.
Ah, another matter.
You got more.
Infusing weapons with gems requires a special kind of gold. My humble coals won't be any use infusing more unusual gems. I know, it's an awful shame, but it's all I have. Oh, please don't give me that look. Believe it or not, I'm quite thin-skinned. Oh, by the way, if you find any Estus shards, bring them here. They can be used to reinforce either of your Estus flasks. Without those flasks, you'd want for life or focus. And they'll always stay with you. Why not treat them well? Huh? Weapons and protection are sturdy enough by and large. But when over you, when you, but I
got it.
Take
okay,
so.
Now we're repeating. All right, let's
Pretty
get out.
Be careful. I don't want to see my work squandered.
Oh, so let's finish exploring Firelink Shrine. I've changed my mind. I'm going to do the item in descriptions in the next video and just have that be a video unto itself. Firelink Shrine a little bit. So what's what? Who's who? Giant who looks a lot like the giant lord from Dark Souls 2. Watchers of the Abyss. I wonder if they've got anything to do with Artorias. So these are the thrones for the Lords of Cinder. Lulleth, exiled. Saint Aldrich of the Deep. That's the black slimy thing. The intro. There's the thrones up there, so it looks like the Eye of the Lord's Ascender. Needs one more side to go down. Shrine. I'll go have one whack at that tough guy we left behind out here. See what that guy even is. We haven't even looked at him yet. And then I'll call it quits. Not much happened in this episode, but not much was supposed to. No illusory wall. I don't know why I thought there might be Ember. See a tough enemy yet, but I guess he's down that other way. Let's run down there, let's run down there. That looks like the tough enemy. Yes, indeed. Screw this guy. All right, I'm gonna end the video here. I will see you guys next time. That guy is monstrously healthy. Okay, bye.